Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our biology session. So as we know, we are discussing the lesson, that is what? Microorganisms, friends and foe. Okay, in this lesson already we have discussed about the some points, and today we will see the next point, that is what? Already we have seen the one point from the uses of microorganisms. Okay, in that what we have discussed uses of microorganism, we have seen that how the microorganisms are used to make the different types of the food stuff or the food atom. In this point today we will see the next use of a microorganism, that is in what? Commercial use. Okay, so the use, there are the certain microorganisms which used commercially, which used on the basis of commercially for production of certain things. Okay, so let's see the uses of microorganisms as a commercial purpose. Okay, so there are the certain microorganisms like that what? Yeast, which is used as a commercial for the production of alcohol, wine, beer and acetic acid. Okay, so the yeast is used for the commercial production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid. Okay, so for this purpose what happened? The yeast is get feed on the natural sugar which is present in the different food grains, like we can say that barley, wheat, rice, and also it is present on the fruit juices. Okay, so the yeast is get feed on the sugar which is present on these following things or the following substances, and in that what happened? That natural sugar get converted into the alcohol, and that process is only called as what? Fermentation. Okay, so what is mean by fermentation? The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol. Okay, so what happens in the fermentation? The natural sugar get converted into alcohol by who? By the action of microbes, that is nothing but what? Yeast. By the action of microbes like yeast, and it is only called as what? Fermentation. Okay, and this fermentation process was discovered by a great scientist, and the name of that scientist was Louis Pasteur. He discovered the fermentation process in 1857. Okay, so the Louis Pasteur discovered the fermentation in 1857. Okay, so this is the one of the biggest use of the microorganisms as a commercial purpose for the production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid. Also there are the certain bacteria are used in the production of tea, coffee and tobacco. Okay, and also the microorganisms are used in the preparation or for to prepare for the making of the different acid. Okay, or the production of the certain acids like lactic acid, citric acid and acetic acid, which is also called as what? Vinegar. Okay, so in this way all these microorganisms and different types of the microorganisms can be used commercially for the production of this wine, alcohol. Also it can use for the production of tea, coffee and tobacco, and also it used for the production of certain acids like lactic acid, citric acid and acetic acid. Okay, so this is the one of the use of microorganism, that is which use commercial use. And now we'll see the next use of microorganism.
It is what? Medicinal used. Okay, in that we will discuss that how the microorganisms are used in the production of antibiotics. Okay, so what is mean by antibiotics? So whenever we feel ill or whenever we are suffering from any disease, then we are going to the doctor, and then doctor prescribe us certain types of the antibiotics. Now what is mean by antibiotics? Why we are taking the antibiotics or how it get produced? Okay, so let's find out the answers of all these questions. Okay, so the production of antibiotics. So microorganism plays a vital role in the production of antibiotics. Okay, so what is mean by antibiotics? The medicines produced by organisms such as bacteria and fungi that kill or stop the growth of the disease causing microorganisms, that we are calling as what? Pathogens. What is mean by pathogens? The disease causing microorganisms are called as what? Pathogens or germs also we can say that. Next one, present in our body are called antibiotics. Okay, so what is mean by antibiotics? The medicine which can get produced with the help of the fungi and certain types of the bacteria, and that medicine can kill or can stop the growth of disease causing microorganisms that means what? Pathogens or germs, and helps to cure the body from the different diseases which are present in our body are called as what? Antibiotics. Okay, so this is a definition of antibiotics. Antibiotics can get made or can get produced with the help of the bacteria and the fungi, and that antibiotics can kill the harmful germs or the pathogens which are present in our body and helps to cure the body from the different diseases. Okay, so the main source to produce the antibiotics is nothing but what? Bacteria and fungi. Okay, so most of the or the antibiotics can get made with the help of the bacteria and the fungi, and then nowadays there are the so many antibiotics are present. Some names we can say that what? Streptomycin is there, tetracycline is there, and erythromycin is there. Okay, or there are the so many other antibiotics which we can commonly use. And the penicillium was the first antibiotics was get prepared. Okay, so the penicillium was the first antibiotics which can get made from the penicillium notatum. Okay, which can get prepared by a fungi, and the name of that fungi is what? Penicillium notatum. Okay, so these all the antibiotics are very useful in the different disease. They can help us to cure the different disease, or they can help us to get cure from the different diseases. These antibiotics can also get mixed with the feed of livestock and poultry, means it can get mixed into the food of an animals, and also it can get mixed into the food of the poultry that we are keeping the hens. Okay, so also mixed up with the feed of livestock and the poultry. Why? To check microbial infection in animals. Okay, so to check the microbial infection in the animals, it can get used, or the antibiotics can get used. Next one is that also it can use to control the different diseases. Okay, so also it can get used to different diseases. So now I have said that the penicillium was the first antibiotics was get discovered. So let's see how it get exactly discovered by the great scientist, and the name of that scientist was Alexander Fleming. Okay, how the discovery of penicillium was happened, let's see. In the year of 1929, Alexander Fleming was working on a culture of disease causing bacteria, and suddenly he found that on the one culture there are the spores of mold. Okay, on the one culture he saw the small spores of mold, and because of the presence of that mold, the number of bacteria which are present in them are getting decreases, and also that mold spore also kill the certain bacteria and they stop the growth of the certain bacteria. Okay, so from there, or in this way, the great scientist Alexander Fleming discovered the antibiotics, that is nothing but what? Penicillium. Okay, so if we are taking the antibiotics, then also we have to follow, or we have to take certain precautions. So which precaution we should take whenever we are taking the antibiotics, let's see. So the antibiotic should be taken only if it is prescribed by a qualified doctor, or if it is advised by a qualified doctor. Okay, next one is that complete the entire dose of antibiotics. If the doctor has given you antibiotic on the any disease, then you should complete that entire dose of antibiotics, because it will helps to improve your immunity system, and in future you will not get infected again with that same disease. Okay, next one is there, not take in a wrong way or when not needed. Okay, so you should not take the antibiotics when it is not needed, and don't take the antibiotics in a wrong doses. Okay, So in this way, what we can say that it may make the antibiotic drug less effective in when we might really need in the future. Okay. Next one is that antibiotics taken unnecessary. If you will take the antibiotics unnecessary, then what will happen? Whatever the beneficial bacteria are present in our body, they will kill that bacteria also. Okay. Next one is that. And antibiotics should not be given on the common cold or on the flu, okay, because that common cold and the flu can be caused because of the viruses. It is causes due to the viruses, so the antibodies will not work on that. So it is not given in the flu and the colds, okay. So all these precautions you should take whenever we are having the or whenever we are taking the antibiotics, okay. So this is the major use of microorganisms in the medicinal field, that is what production of antibiotics. Okay, so dear students, now let's move for the next use of microorganism, that is production of vaccine. Okay, production of vaccine, that microorganisms can be used in the production of vaccine also. So let's discuss how the microorganisms are being used in the production of vaccine. Okay, let's see how the microorganisms are used in the production of vaccines. Okay, so as we know, the microorganisms are also used in the production of the vaccine, and these vaccines are the substance which protects the animals and the human beings from the certain types of the diseases. Okay, or they helps to increase the immunity system of a human being for a particular diseases or for the different diseases. Okay, so what is mean by immunity system? The ability of one's body to resist a disease is called immunity. Okay, so the ability of a body to resist means what? How our body can resist, how our body can fight against different disease, and that power, that system is called as which system? Immunity system, or it is called as what? Immunity. See dear student, nowadays we are telling that we should maintain our immunity system, because in this time or this day to day life, we are suffering from the one type of the microorganism only, that is nothing but what? Virus is there, and for to avoid the infection of that virus, we should develop our immunity system by having the healthy food. Okay, so if our immunity system is good, then we can easily fight with that different types of the microorganisms. Okay, so this is about immunity, and we can boost the immunity system, we can maintain or we can develop the immunity against the particular diseases by the process, and that process is called as what? Vaccination. By providing the vaccine, we can develop the immunity system against the certain disease, which is called as what? Vaccination. Okay, the immunity against a particular disease can be developed. Okay, we can develop the immunity system against a particular disease by a technique called as what? Vaccination, which is called as what? Vaccination. Okay, next one, what is mean by vaccine? Okay, so let's see what is mean by vaccine. A small dose of dead and weakened disease causing microbes. Okay, very important two words are there, dead and weakened disease causing microbes. A small dose of dead and weakened disease causing microbes used to stimulate the immune response in the body is called vaccine. So what is mean by the vaccine? We are taking the vaccine, or the small children are given the different types of the vaccine. So that vaccine, what it exactly contain? That vaccine, that medicine contain the weakened or the partially dead microbes. Okay, what? The disease causing microbes. Why we are releasing that disease causing microbes or that partially dead disease causing microbe in our body? To stimulate our immunity system. Okay, to stimulate the immunity system, immune response in the body is called vaccine. Okay, so see, they are the partially dead or the weakened microbes are there. Okay, so our body can easily fight with that microbes. Okay, and in future, if that same bacteria will enter in our body, then our body is ready for the protection of from that certain types of the microbes. Okay, for that reason we should take the different types of the vaccine time to time, or we should provide the different types of the vaccine to the small children time to time. Okay, again I will repeat, a small dose of dead and the weakened disease causing microbes used to stimulate immune response in the body is called vaccine. Okay, so that vaccine is introduced into the healthy person's body, and that when we are introducing that vaccine, or the vaccine can be given by with the help of the orally or with the help of the injection. Okay, so when the vaccine is get introduced in the healthy person's body, then that vaccine is act as a antigen. Okay, then what is mean by antigen? Antigen means what? It is the one type, it act as a one type of the substance, or it act as a foreign substance which enters in our body and start to produce certain type of the diseases, or start to causes the different diseases. Okay, so this is about what? Antigen. So whenever we introducing vaccine in someone's body or in the healthy person body, then that vaccine is act as a antigen. What is mean by antigen? Any foreign substance which enters in the body and start to causes the disease. Okay, so that vaccine is to act like a antigen, and the healthy person's body produce the antibodies as a result of antigens. Okay, so when we are adding the introducing vaccine in the healthy person's body, then it act as a antigen, and to give the response to that antigens, that healthy person's body start to produce the antibodies. Okay, that healthy person's body start to produce the antibodies. So what is mean by antibodies? Let's see what is mean by antibodies. So proteins produced in the body in response to entry of antigens to render them harmless. Okay, so see, antigens are introduced in our body, but it is necessary to protect our body from that antigen. So our body started to produce antibodies, okay, to kill that antigens. And what is mean by antibodies? Antibodies is nothing but the proteins. Okay, these are the proteins which helps, or these are the proteins produced in the body in the response to entry of antigens. Okay, so when that antigen enters in someone's body, our body started to produce antibodies. And what is mean by antibodies? These are the certain types of the proteins which makes the that bacteria or any type of the microorganism harmless. That bacteria or the any type of the microorganisms harmless. So this is about what? Antibodies and antigen. Don't get confused among the antigen and antibodies. Antigen, these are the foreign substances which enters in our body and start to causes diseases. And antibodies means what? When the antigen enters in our body to fight against them, our body started to produce antibodies. Okay, that antibodies kills the antigens. Okay, in this way, so that healthy person's body produce the antibodies, and that antibodies remain in that person's body and helps that person's body to fight against the diseases. If in a future, if that same type of the bacteria or that same type of the microbes enters in that person's body, then that antibodies can help the person's body to fight against that microbes. Okay, so these micro antibodies remain in the person's body for the long period of the time and protect him or her against the future infection of the same microbes. Okay, so there are the several diseases which can be cured by vaccine. So the diseases, we can say that cholera is there, tuberculosis is there, smallpox, tetanus, polio, hepatitis B, all these are the different diseases which can be get cured with the help of the vaccine. Okay, so these, as we know, the vaccine can be given orally or can be get injected. So there is only one vaccine which are given orally, that is nothing but what? Polio. Okay, so National Pulse Polio Program is practiced to eradicate polio from the different country. Eradicated means what? To remove this disease from the country. In this program, what happened? Under the age of 5 or the children below the age of the 5 are given the polio vaccine regularly to maintain their immunity system against the polio. Okay, so this polio is given orally, that polio drops are given orally. Okay, and in the childhood or in the small baby up till the age of the 1 day to up till the age of the 5 years, there are so many different vaccines we have to give to the small children. Okay, so there is a one chart about that different vaccines that I am giving you in the notes. Okay, so that timetable, there is a one schedule for the vaccine of the small children, and that schedule is called as what? Immunization schedule. Okay, that schedule is called as immunization schedule. Okay, so about the vaccine, and the Edward Jenner discovered the vaccine for the smallpox in the year 1798. Okay, so Edward Jenner discovered the vaccine against smallpox in 1798. Okay, so this is all about today. We have discussed about the uses of microorganisms, in that we have discussed about the medicinal use, in that we have discussed the first use of the medicinal, that is what? Production of antibiotics. Also we have discussed about the production of vaccine. Okay, so here we will stop. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.